Hello and welcome. We're at the track covering the sport of kings. Coming up, the Reggae Trophy and Kenneth Mattis Memorial main events from Jamaica's Caymanas Park. Caribbean jockeys Sean Bridgemahon and Patrick Husbands land added money wins at Woodbine in Toronto, while the Barbadian jockey Chris Husbands aces the Rondo Bay Stakes at nearby Fort Erie. And we also have the Canadian Derby from Edmonton Centromile Racetrack. First to Jamaica's Caymanas Park.
The 11 horse field for the Reggae Trophy over 5 furlong straight includes number 5, the favorite Rejoin the Pilot, his only win this year coming over the straight course, informed Dick Cardenas in the saddle. A pretty even race early with 4-1 bet, the Grey Salvation on the outside setting the pace, along with a bunch of horses in the middle ready to strike, including Rejoin the Pilot, who is close enough if good enough, as Bran Rickman picks up the race call.
As they come thundering past the 3, Salvation possibly has the overall lead. Patriarch continuing to tack across. Rejoin the Pilot in the center. Harry's train has to be switched with no room. As they run inside the last quarter, it is Salvation. But here is Patriarch now kicking in. Rejoin the Pilot needs to do more. The Great Duke now finding his best stride as they come charging up inside the final furlong in the Reggae Trophy. It is Patriarch who holds the lead. Rejoin the Pilot on his inside. These two going at it. Duke now trying to fly on the outside, but they drive toward the line. Rejoin the Pilot beats Patriarch.
2 wins now in 2021, both over the straight course. Rejoin the Pilot does it in the Reggae Trophy as a 7-5 favorite, with Dick Cardenas aboard by 3/4 of a length over the 7-1 shot Patriarch. 58 1/5 of a second the winning time for trainer Ian Prasad and owners Rome. Cardenas says he measured his race off a horse he's had many victories aboard and knows well, Patriarch.
You know, I know Patriarch is the fastest horse in the race, but so I break and sit on close to him and I wait to him and drift a little bit to the right. I'm pass full.
The midweek feature at Caymanas Park was the Kenneth Mattis OD Memorial, run in honor of the former top jockey and champion trainer, the only person to be inducted twice in the Hall of Fame of Thoroughbred Racing in Jamaica, first as a jockey, then as a trainer. And can they beat the 4-1 bet money monster here? He's taking control, coming off the final bend.
5/16 of a mile to run. They're about to come into the lane in the Kenneth Mattis OD Memorial Trophy. And Roy Rogers has given way. Money Monster now snatches the lead and is asked to accelerate by the rider, and does. As they slip past the 3/16, it is a Money Monster out in front in the hands of the former champion Omar Walker. They leave the furlong pole. Roy Rogers is in chase but needs to find some 3 or 4 lengths inside the final 16th. It is a Money Monster and Omar Walker. They're running away from them to win the Kenneth Mattis OD Memorial Trophy. Roy Rogers second.
Omar Walker steers Money Monster home in the Kenny Mattis Memorial. The 4-year-old snapping a 7-race winless streak with a solid 2 1/4 length win here at odds of 4-1 over Roy Rogers. The 5-2 favorite Hovercraft third, bred, owned and trained by 8-time classic winning jockey Fitzroy Glisby. Money Monster clocks 1:54 4/5 for the 9th furlong and 25-yard trip.
Let's head now to Canada's Woodbine Racetrack, where the Barbadian jockey Patrick Bommel Husbands had another prosperous weekend. 7 wins, including a meet leading 9th stakes triumph on Sunday.
In the Bell Mahone Stakes, Husbands is here in the whitecap aboard the favorite Sky Gaze, a daughter of 2015 US Triple Crown winner American Farah, coming up on the outside as a commentator Bob Getter takes them into the home stretch.
Going to the front, Sky Gaze to join Fate Factor. They're stride to stride. Sky Gaze, the outsider, head clear, coming off the rails. No More Lady and Art of Almost swings 4 wide. Crystal Glacier coming home nicely behind the pack. Into the stretch in the Bell Mahone, Sky Gaze gets out in front. Crystal Glacier running for the back, down the outside coming, and No More Lady and Art of Almost. Sky Gaze in front, and Sky Gaze getting out in the lead for Patrick Husbands clear. Sky Gaze burning away from them. And this is a talent. Sky Gaze has won the Bell Mahone by about 3. Crystal Glacier second.
Sky Gaze scores with authority in the Bell Mahone by 3 lengths as the 8-5 favorite for champion trainer Mark Cassie. She went 8.5 furlongs in 1:42.73. Patrick Husbands, Canada's 8-time Sovereign Award winner as Jockey of the Year, closes a solid weekend. 2 wins Friday, 3 more on Saturday, and a double on Sunday. And said post-race that after a 3rd-place finish aboard the filly in June, he decided on a different approach this time.
Last time when I rode her, you know, she was a little bit quiet and stuff like that. So today I went alone and warm her up, because showing on the form, she liked to be in the race. And the last time when I rode her, she was flat the whole way with me, flat the whole way. But she tried, and it was the best race she ran, you know, in bars and in numbers, you know. But today's saying I warm her up, And for them to warm her up, she showed me that she really wanted to be in the race. So I leave the gates and I was want to put her in the race and get her in the race and show she was the best.
Jamaican jockey Sean Bridgemahon also grabbed some of the spotlight on Sunday. In the day's richest event, the Toronto Cup, he was aboard the three-horse War Bomber, unfancied at 19-1. But Bridgemahon is close to the lead here in a tight bunch.
Still out in front, it's on the inside of Zero Barnegat Light. Here they come out wide. Gretzky the Great and Lenny Kaye. Artie Storm waiting for a run in the center. And as they come down the home stretch, going to the front, Gretzky the Great from Barnegat Light. Lenny Kaye, Riptide Rocks right down the outside. Out in front, Gretzky the Great on the inside. War Bomber, Riptide Rock trying to get them both. War Bomber on the insides, hit the front. War Bomber from Gretzky the Great. And up the rails now is Artie Storm lead. But it's War Bomber who's devastated them in the Toronto Cup. Sean Bridgemahon, War Bomber by about 2 lengths.
What a rallying win this for Bridgemahon. The 1998 Eclipse Award winner as the USA's top apprentice rider pulls clear for the upset win in the Toronto Cup by 2 lengths aboard the 19-1 bet War Bomber, clocking 134.14 over the mile trip on turf. The 42-year-old Bridgemahon, who recently moved from the USA to Canada, very satisfied with the run.
I had a beautiful trip. I mean, there was a little bit of speed in there and I opted to follow and obviously at the end try to find him clear daylight, and once I did and I pointed him for a hole, he just went.
Still in Ontario, Patrick Husband skipped across to Fort Erie for Tuesday's Rich Prince of Wales Stakes and was fifth aboard the 7-2 favourite Curlin's Catch. But in this Rondo Bay Stakes, a Caribbean winner as well, Barbadian jockey Christopher Chin's Husband in the black cap here, travelling best, coming up on the outside.
Into the stretch. They're in the lane after a half in 45-4. Sunsprite still out widest. Red Equinox has picked off the leaders and come on through against Benny's Button. Benny's Button, Red Equinox, and Sunrise. It's Red Equinox. Chris Husband's almost there. Red Equinox scores in the Rondo Bay Stakes over Sunsprite.
Red Equinox was well supported in the betting at 5-2, but was not expected to beat the 4-5 favorite Sunsprite. A length of victory margin, 111.01 for 6 furlongs in the Rondo Bay, giving trainer Jamie Attard from the famous Attard family his first stakes win. And Chris Husband's a runaway Fort Erie's jockeys leader, happy with a pretty straightforward victory.
She broke pretty good and I was sitting pretty comfortable. Coming to the tree, I thought I had her already saddled on her, but she just picked up. I kind of ran up on heels a bit, but she recovered. And when I pressed the button, she came again.
Staying in Canada, but to Centre Mile in Edmonton, where Western Canada's richest horse race, the Canadian Derby, went off on Saturday. Lots of Caribbean interest, trainer Lionel Joseph and jockeys Rico Walcott, Antonio Whitehall, Dane Nelson and Andre Martin all had entries in the 10 furlong run.
Barbadian jockey Walcott, eyeing his fifth Canadian Derby triumph, is aboard the number 3 horse Myopic, the 3-2 favourite. Antiguan trainer Joseph starts the 4-horse Papi Chulo, with Jamaican Andre Martin riding. Joseph's other entry, Buck West, the 10-horse, has Barbadian Antonio Whitehall aboard. And Jamaican Dane Nelson rides the 7-horse Major Shepherd at long odds of 64-1. Heading for the home stretch, 4 horses bunching title in the Canadian $125,000 event. Walcott in the white silks and blue cap, producing Myopic with a threatening run as we go to the race call.
And down the lane they come in the 92nd Canadian Derby. And Myopic with a short lead. But here's the gray, uncharacteristic, grandstand side. Smart play right there, and Tony's tap it. It's uncharacteristic and Myopic as they come to pass the 16th pole. Uncharacteristic Myopic smart play. The Manitoba Derby, now the Canadian Derby, to uncharacteristic.
Canadian Derby wins for Walcott in 2010, 2013, 2014 and 2018, but not this time on characteristic. At 7-2 gets the win with Alexander Marty aboard, scoring by 3/4 of a length over Walcott's mount Myopic. The winning time 2:04.16 for uncharacteristic, adding to his Manitoba Derby win last month at Assiniboia Downs and giving trainer Robert Van Overshot his first Canadian Derby win.
We've been at the track covering top stories and exciting races in the sport of kings. Check us out again next week.